And as promised, joining us today in studio is Stephanie Clary of the great Diocese of Burlington, Vermont. That's Bishop Coyne's diocese. Stephanie, thank you so much for making the drive all the way down today.
Thank you for having me. It's great to be here.
How was the drive, by the way?
It was lovely. You know,
he must have left at like 3 a.m.
Yeah, something like that. But it's beautiful to drive down 89 this time of year, so it was enjoyable.
Very good. Well, we're glad you're here, and we're glad you had a nice trip. And mission outreach and communications, that seems to be a vast title and role. Can you tell us about the work that you do with
Sure.
Bishop Coyne in the Diocese of Burlington?
Sure. So for mission outreach and communication, my role is to coordinate the communication throughout the diocese, which we do primarily through our Vermont Catholic publications, but then also through our diocesan social media networks. And to always do that, coordinate those communication components and also work for community engagement and outreach with the mission of the church in mind, meaning the general mission of the Catholic Church, but also any particular focus we might be taking in our diocese.
Now, I have to ask you this, if you don't mind. What's it like having this kind of a role with a bishop who is also the chairman of the Communications Committee for the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops? I mean, that must be a challenge, or very exciting.
It's very exciting, right? Of course, we want to make sure that we're doing a great job, because we know he does an awesome job with his own communication, his blog, and his different shows that he's done here on Catholic TV. But all in all, it's wonderful, and we have a lot of support and a lot of great things that have come from it.
Very good. Well, now, this year has been set aside as the year of creation, and so that's what we really want to talk about here today. So what has been planned? What's going on?
Great. We have a lot of great things planned. We have some programs and some events. And so a few of the programs that we've started, we've kind of rolled out from the diocese so far, are an energy efficiency audit program for any of the buildings that the diocese owns within the state, since our diocese is the whole state of Vermont.
Sure.
So right now we have about 20 buildings which have started this process to do an energy efficiency audit, and then hopefully follow that up with a project that is suggested in that audit that will result in energy savings. So we have Catholic Charities, residential care homes, some of our schools, parishes, rectories, the Chancery Building itself, all jumping on board with this, and we hope that program will continue to grow. Then we also have been learning more about how we manage our waste materials. We've started composting at the Chancery, and a lot of our schools practice composting as well, and some of our parishes and halls have started doing that. In the way of events, we've had everything kind of planned within the context of prayer, education, and action. So, for example, at the beginning of Lent, we did an event called On the Path of Ecological Conversion, which paired the Stations of the Cross, which had a script including St. John Paul II's ecological writings, and then followed that up with kind of an education presentation on the history of fasting within our faith tradition, and a sustainable soup and bread supper, which was locally sourced and meat-free, dairy-free, seasonal ingredients. So,
wow, very impressive.
It's been wonderful, and we've had a great response from people, good attendance at our events. We did another one on Divine Mercy Sunday, which had Vespers paired with roundtable discussions. We had another event that our Catholic schools participated in, Catholic Schools Care for Creation Day. So it's really been met very well, and we've been so encouraged by the participation of the folks in Vermont.
And all of this must have been in some way encouraged, at least, or inspired by the encyclical Laudato Si from Pope Francis, I'm just presuming.
Absolutely. With Laudato Si being a few years out now, and a lot of resources having been produced by different organizations and the church itself, we knew that there was a lot there, a lot that could be tapped into, a lot that could be offered to our parishes, and we're working with some of those other organizations to use their resources in the best way possible with our parishes.
The slogan, serving God in all things, seems to be relevant for young people and everyone. How did you pick that as a slogan, and why do those words represent this year for creation?
We picked that slogan for a few reasons. There is a line in Laudato Si where Pope Francis says the ideal is to discover God in all things. And so that had really stuck out to us as we were ourselves reflecting on the document. But then we also are becoming so aware of the wonderful service work that our parishes are doing, and our students and our staff and our schools are doing. And so thinking along both of those lines, you know, we want to discover God in all things and then therefore serve God in all things in every way that we can. And so that also makes it a topic that resonates with a lot more people than perhaps just the environmentalist.
Sure.
So all things, whether this is a human component, a non-human creature, the earth itself, water, air, or another area in Laudato Si, speaking of economics or science or advocacy, we can tap into all of these areas and reach out to a much broader group of people by talking about all things and how we serve God through our relationships with everything.
Now, because you do such a great job of communication, see, I know that you have a diocesan synod being planned, too.
We do.
Very, very exciting.
It is.
Yeah, and that's the first one, I think, since just after the Second Vatican Council.
Right.
See how much I know because you just do such a great job.
Oh, that's great. And we're glad you're following our social media.
I follow everything that goes on in Burlington. And where can other people do that? Can you tell us about the website so we can learn more about the great things going on in the church in Burlington, but also the Year for Creation?
Sure. So there's a website that is vermontcatholic.org/year of creation, and that will soon have information about our upcoming conference, which will be Action for Ecological Justice, celebrating a year of creation with Dr. Carolyn Wu from CRS. And the registration will be on that website very soon, as well as a lot of other things about the year of creation. The best way to get daily updates from our diocese is to like our Facebook page, Roman Catholic Diocese of Burlington.
Perfect. And speaking about information, first of all, thank you so much again for taking the trip down, for being with us. And I hope that you will, as you watch, when you're done with the show, go and check all that out. But you know who has all the information? Is Kevin Nelson. And Kevin Nelson has slipped away to the news desk. Hey, Kevin, what's going on all around the world and the Catholic Church?